In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is Father Deacon Angel Palacios from the Mission of St. Andrew in Tijuana, Baja California, Mexico, from the Diocese of Mexico of the Orthodox Church in America. The Gospel is for the 4th of November 2018, according to St. Mark. You shall love your God with all your heart. One of the scribes came to Jesus and asked him, "Which is the first of all commandments?" Jesus replied, "The first is this, 'Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is our Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength.' The second is this, 'You shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than this.' The scribe said to him, 'Well said, teacher. You are right in saying he is one and there is no other than he. And to love him with all your heart, with all your understanding, and with all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself, is worth more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices.' And when Jesus saw that he answered with understanding, he said to him, 'You are not far from the kingdom of God.' And no one dared to ask him any more questions. Glory be to thee, O God, glory be to thee." There is in my heart that is wicked a certain rebuttal of this doctor of the law, of this scribe, because he's like stressing the point that there is only one God and there is no other. And there was this claim that Jesus was the Son of God, and I believe that he truly did not believe it. He understood and he remembered perhaps the commandments, and certainly he understood, at least in his mind, that to do that would be worth more than any sacrifice or holocaust. But let us get back to what is important. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart. Do we really do that? Because truly that is the main commandment. If we were to love God with all our heart, with all our life, with all our mind, and with all our strength, then everything else will follow. Loving our neighbor as being loved by God, not out of love, even if there would be no love in me for my neighbor, but because I love God with all my heart, with all my strength, then I would have to love him who my love above celestial love loves. And thus, it would only be natural for me to love everyone in mankind, because God loves mankind. He loves me, he loves you, and he loves everyone. He loves even the sinners. He does want everyone, every woman, every person in the world to be saved. That was the purpose of his Son coming into incarnation through the blessed womb of the Holy Virgin, so that we might be all saved. But do you love God in that way? Many times we would like to manipulate the way we think God is. We would like to manipulate whatever it is that we want. And then we think, reasoning, that if we comply with such and such commandments of our own choosing, then we are all right with God. But never do we turn around and look at the Theotokos, the only creature which I truly believe really loved God with all her soul, with all her heart, with all her mind, and with all her strength. First of all, she listened to God. Then she was obedient out of love, even unto worse than death, because to see her only son dying on the cross and not being even upset against God or upset against the ones that were crucifying her son is something incredible, something that only the dwelling of the Holy Spirit in her soul, in her body, in her reins could produce. And that is that the Holy Spirit, as the Archangel Gabriel told her, "Here ke charitomene," that is, "Rejoice, O full of grace." or full of the Holy Spirit. Can only be full because she loves fully. You see? Do you want to be saved? Do you want to go along the path of salvation? You need to learn to love God above everything. That you should take not into account whether you're tired, whether you want to do something else. Especially you, my brothers in the presbytery. Work for God until you are exhausted. I mean, on a daily basis. Not until you are sick or ill. That would not be very good. You have to be smart, but we have to work ourselves. Truly work for Him. And may He who is merciful and loves us more than we can ever imagine, create in us the true love that is owed to Him.